Welcome back to K&L Farms. Some stuff we need to go over just for an update a little bit. So, Woodland Mill, previous video, I took possession of it, and I've been cutting maybe 3 or 4 days so far. But I got through about 7 logs before I had to change the factory blade that was on it. And I had purchased other blades when I bought the machine, but I'll show you here in just a minute. And you leave in the comment which one you like better or worse. In just a minute, I'll show you. And the saw's not running currently, and the tractor's not running because I get too much background noise. You can't hear it very well. So these are 6x6s. I know I need 6x6s. And I know I need for the building. And if you don't know about the building, you have to go back on my playlist or back to my YouTube channel and catch up with the rest of us. But I know I need 4x6s and I need 6x6s. Okay. Now the thing is the factory blade. I'll get a smaller fork for you. Saw blades for it. I didn't know the tooth count, what tooth count was correct. And this is the factory blade that was on it when I ran the saws. It got dull, I had to replace it. And when I replaced it, the finish went from that . Now this is a 12 footer, but that's okay. You can still get a pretty good example. Nope, that's not it. It went to this. See that face? I'm not sure I like that face, but what it is the factory blade had more teeth on it, and the blades that I bought have less teeth on it. So those are the two finishes. And leave in the comments which one you like better or worse. And I just wanted to show some appreciation to the subscribers I have and the support I'm getting on the channel. But if you're watching the channel and you like this content, please like and subscribe. Now I'm gonna go run that. I might even move you over so you can see better, but I know that I'm gonna need some 48s. Let me rephrase, I guess. I'm going to need some 4 foot pieces that are 4 inches by 4 inches in diameter. And that piece on the sawmill currently is a 5 footer. Now I know that these 6x6s, starting out, I want to be longer than 10 feet. And these 4x6s here, I want to be at least 12 feet long. Now that's the thing too, if you're doing rough lumber or you go to buy rough lumber, the length, they call it running wild. The length, so that, this might be, I know that this 6x6 is 10'3", and I want, I don't care at this point. I know that this 4x6 is 12'3", don't care at this point. All of this gets shipped down the hill down to the building site at a later time. And if you haven't concluded as of yet, it's going to be a timber frame building. And I've done my share of stick frame building, but I've never done any timber frame buildings, so I know less about this than most probably, but I'm learning. And that's just like the sawmill. I've never ran a portable sawmill a day in my life, and I'm learning. And and I've concluded that approximately 7 logs is the life of a blade. And but you can take the blades down and get them sharpened, but I've got a dull blade in the work truck, and I've got a new blade on the sawmill right now, and I'm going to try and cut that down to 4x4s. Now these pieces, I have to get the tractor. I can't move them by myself, but I can't think I can move a 4x4 that's 5 foot long by myself. I'm going to shift you from that location down to here,
and get some of my safety gear on, get the sawmill started, and then
cut some. You can see me cutting some 4x4s up, but okay, I'm gonna move you down the hill a little bit. Yeah, it looks like from there you can see it pretty well. Okay, I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna start it up and get it warmed up a little bit. Okay, so that's roughly 4x4-ish out of that log. And you can see probably 5 feet, but I know I need 46, 48 inches long. So I just leave them alone. Remember, if you like this content, please like and subscribe. Thank you. Have a good day.